Hi guys, in this lesson, we're going to have a look at CNAME and alias records. It's going to be hands-on. I'm going to take you into Route 53, and we're just going to see the differences between these different types of resource record because that's super important for the exam. I'm logged into an account where I have a Route 53 public hosted zone, and we're going to go to dctcloudlabs.com. Now, this is where I'm going to create my resource records. The first record I'm going to create is going to be an A record. So let's just create an A record here for dctcloudlabs.com. Now this is where you choose the record types. A record routes traffic to an IP address. So it's a domain name and then an IP address value. So that's not even a public IP address, but all I want to do is see the resolution working from the command line. Now it's optional whether you have a record name. If you don't, then the record name will essentially be dctcloudlabs.com or whatever your domain name is. Now, you can also change the time to live for your records and you can specify routing. Now, we're just using simple routing here, so we're not using any of that clever, intelligent routing. Let's just create this record. So now we have our A record. Now, the other two records here are the start of authority and the name server records. This is stuff that you don't want to delete. Make sure you leave these alone. So now I'm going to go over to a command line and I'm just going to use the dig utility. You can use nslookup if you're on Windows. With dig, I'm just going to put in dctcloudlabs.com and hit enter. And so I get a DNS resolution. We can see the resolution here. Our A record is resolved from dctcloudlabs.com to this specific IP address. So that works exactly as expected. What we're going to do next is we're going to create another record, but this time we're actually going to give it a record name. So let's call this one My App. And I'll give this one the IP address 192.168.0.2. So again, it's going to be an A record. Let's create that record. And if we come back, I'm going to clear my screen. And I'll use dig or you can use nslookup. And I'm going to try and resolve myapp.dctcloudlabs.com. And again, of course, you get the A record response for that particular domain name, and the response is 192.168.0.2. So coming back in, we're going to create a CNAME record now. So a CNAME will map from one domain name to another one. So I'm going to choose CNAME for the record type, and I'm going to put myapp.dctcloudlabs.com as the value. Now, if I try and create this record, we will get an error. So let's just see what that is. So we get an error because the CNAME cannot be permitted at the apex. So the apex is dctcloudlabs.com. So because I didn't put a record name in here, it's trying to create a CNAME for dctcloudlabs.com, which is the zone apex. And remember from the slides before, that's not allowed. So what I could do here instead is let's put in dev.dctcloudlabs.com, and then we can create our record. So we now have a CNAME record, and the CNAME record will map from this domain name, dev.dctcloudlabs.com, to this one, myapp.dctcloudlabs.com. And of course, then your computer will need to resolve that one to the actual IP address to be able to connect. So back in the command line, I'm just going to clear my screen, and I'm going to use dig and put in dev.dctcloudlabs.com. Hit enter, and of course now, I get two different responses. I get dev.dctcloudlabs.com, which is a CNAME for myapp.dctcloudlabs.com, and then I get the myapp.dctcloudlabs.com to the actual IP address. So that's exactly as expected. For the next exercise, we're going to create a static website on S3, and then we're going to create an alias record that points to that static website. So let's go to S3, and I'm going to choose to create a bucket. I'm just going to give this some kind of random name. So hopefully that will be a unique bucket name. Now I'm going to enable ACLs by the bucket owner. I'm going to disable this block all public access option and acknowledge. And then we're just going to scroll down and create this bucket. So I'm going to choose my bucket and then under properties, let's scroll all the way to the bottom here. Edit under static website hosting. We're going to click on enable. And then I'm going to specify index.html and error.html. And then we can go down and save the changes. So now we actually need those objects. So let's upload, click on add files. And in my code S3 directory, I'm just going to select these two files, index and error.html. And then I'm simply going to scroll down and upload. So I have my two objects uploaded. And what I'm going to do now is actually select these objects, go to actions, and make public using ACL. So when I do that, I will enable public access for these objects. So now if I go back to properties, scroll down to the bottom, I've got this URL. So I should be able to access this static website. And sure enough, that S3 URL takes us to the static website and gives us this message. So we now have a static website running on S3. Let's go back to Route 53. We're going to go back into our hosted zone, and I'm going to create an alias record now. Now, before I do that, I do want to delete this A record here because I'm going to use the zone apex. So let's delete this record. We're going to create a new record, and we're going to use the zone apex. So unlike a CNAME with an alias, you can use the zone apex, and that simply means we're going to use the root here, dctcloudlabs.com, not some kind of subdomain. I'm going to still choose A record, but then I'm going to flick this box to enable alias. And now we can choose from the various different endpoint types that are supported on AWS. So I'm going to choose S3 endpoint, choose region, US East North Virginia, and then let's find our static website. And here it is. So we choose the website endpoint and then create records. So now we have an alias record that points from dctcloudlabs.com to our S3 bucket. So I'm going to open a new tab here, paste this in, hit enter, and now using the domain name dctcloudlabs.com, we can see our static website on S3.